In this video, I'll show you how to import the profiles into the SAP system. Actually, what are all the profiles? Profiles are main point of starting SAP system. With the help of profiles only, the SAP system will be started. All the profile files are available inside the computer. Double click on C drive and USR folder, SAP folder. In that dev, sys and profile. With this profile folder file only, default.pf only, we have installed distributed environment systems, that is database instance and central instance. Okay, each and every time if you are making some changes, that default profile will be renamed as 1, 2, 3, and it will be stored as in secured place. That means you can use these previous profile files to troubleshoot the problems. And the remaining profiles also available, that is this is one profile, this is one profile, and these are all the profiles. One is start profile, another is instance profile, there another is default profile. There are three profiles available. There is a separate class for profile maintenance and the parameters changing. I will explain details about these profiles in that class. And right now, just remember that we are going to import these profiles into the SAP system for changing some parameters. Okay, now go to SAP system. To import the profiles into the SAP system, you have to enter RZ10T code. Hit enter. And here, if you click on this possible options button or F4 from the keyboard, you will not, you cannot see any profiles, no profiles found. So if you want to change some parameter inside the SAP system, you have to import the profiles at operating system in this SAP level. Okay, to import the profile, just click on the utilities, import profiles of active servers, so that whatever the files are available at operating system level, those will be imported within the SAP system, so that we can maintain the profiles very easily using SAP screens. Okay, so this is the importing of profiles, display profile check log. It is a log information, so it has imported all the profiles, like you can see profile import executed correctly, and what all the profiles logged in, imported. It will show everything here, like see, this is the profile path, profile start underscore dvabmgs00. And these are all the profiles imported. Okay, just go back from here and click on this possible options button to see the profiles. So this is the default profile. Mostly we will use this particular profile file to change any settings within the SAP system. Just you can double click and you click on change. I'll explain you how to change one profile parameter called default client in next video. I hope you understood how to import profiles inside SAP system in this video. So that's all. Thanks for watching.